Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us understand what is Deep Java Library, called as DJL. Deep Java Library is an open source library created by Amazon to develop machine learning and deep learning models natively in Java. DJL is designed to be easy to get started with and simple to use for Java developers. DJL provides a set of high-level APIs to train, test, and run inferences. Java developers can develop their own models or utilize pre-trained models developed by data scientists in Python from their Java code. DJL provides a convenient abstraction layer for using the most popular AI/ML frameworks such as Apache, MXNet, PyTorch, and TensorFlow. With DJL API, you are getting a uniform and consistent layer that can interact with all of these frameworks, allowing you to swap out the framework of your choice without any impact to the client code.
In this diagram,
as I said earlier, the DJL is an abstraction layer. It will help you to connect to any of the DL framework. So now currently it supported MXNet, PyTorch, ONNX, Runtime, and TensorFlow. So the top layer is Java applications. You can develop the Java applications and it will use the DJL APIs. This is a kind of abstraction layer. Then DJL layer in turn connect to the corresponding framework. You can choose which framework you want to use it. Maybe before even starting the development, you can choose the framework. Then you can go for the development. But whenever required, you can switch the framework. So because of the abstraction layer, there will not be any impact. So then the DL frameworks or the ML frameworks connect to the hardware. So you can choose, even you can set which hardware services it should be, it's going to interact. So let's see some of the highlights using this deep Java library called as DJL. The first one is obviously deep Java library is an open source library. So you can see those details in this GitHub. AWS labs slash DJL, you can refer this code. It will show you all the supported frameworks, PyTorch, TensorFlow, and MXNet, and all those detail. So you can refer this, like how to use it also. Now, the second one is developers can build, train, and deploy machine learning and deep learning models using Java and their favorite IDE. You can use the Java, any of your favorite IDE to develop the models and train them. Now, DJL simplifies the use of deep learning frameworks and it currently supports Apache MXNet, PyTorch, and TensorFlow. This is a abstraction layer, so you can switch the frameworks whenever you want. So DJL can also be configured with different underlying engines. So whenever required, you can switch that. So any engine can, it can connect to any of the engines, supported engines. So use native Java concept and abstract away complexity involved with deep learning. So this will use the native Java concept and it's providing an abstract layer. And so you are abstracted from the framework complexities. The obviously is a open source. The open source nature of DJL should be like mutually beneficial for the toolkit and its user. So there is a lot of improvements the open source forums. So you will get that benefit too. So already we discussed this is a engine agnostic, which means developers can write code once and run it on any engine. So you can write it, start with one engine, then later you want to switch, you can switch the engine. So obviously this is a Java functionality too, like write once and run anywhere. So it will follow the same pattern. So at least Java developers should be having the basic understanding of ML lifecycle and common ML terms before attempting to use the DJL, but they don't want to be an expert in machine learning to use this framework. So to ensure the best performance, DJL also provides automatic CPU, GPU choice based on hardware configuration. So it will automatically choose because it's kind of a system dependent, but it will help you to automatically identify which CPU, GPU you are running in. So based on that, it will function. So DJL offers a repository of pre-trained models in our model zoo. So it will have a trained model. So you will be able to use that for your project. Yeah, so now let's see some more detail on those documentation and all those things. So you can read through here. Also here, if you see like there is a documentation link, you can go to that. This will give you all the detail, how to load a model, how to collect metrics and all those details.
It's required to start with your development.
Refer the Java API details from here. So java.api references. So it will give you all the API details. So it's have a multi sections. So you say like core, the DJL core API, DJL dataset, DJL basic model zoo. We already discussed the model zoo is the one. It will provide you the to use the pre-trained models. The existing pre-trained models you can use. For that you are going to use this module, model zoo. Then each engine, MXNet engine, then MXNet model zoo, then PyTorch. Same thing for TensorFlow also. So you can read through. So what is the usage of each class? So maybe you can understand more on this. Also like there is something called quick start URL. You can see docs DJL.ai docs quick start. So it will give you some examples and beginners tutorial. Even you can read through this. You can even use Jupyter examples. So what you want to use it. Yep. Okay, in this video we seen the details on what is DJL, a deep Java library, and the details, the functionality around that. Maybe in our next video we can see how to use DJL to build and deploy deep learning in Java. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.